My research is often motivated by solving practical applications, especially if there's an opportunity to save lives. We use very intense lasers to look at what is known as nonlinear interactions between light and matter. The problem is that very intense laser is going to melt anything it interacts with, and you're not going to be able to get to the nonlinear optical part. The much better mechanism to look at nonlinear optics is to start with a very low intensity but long pulse, and then to compress the pulse duration. Typical compressions that we use is, for example, factor of a million. And now you have a million times more intensity with the same energy. We started working on compressing pulses in the year 2000. 2 years later, we're able to make the first measurements, we send the publication, and we get the most horrendous reviews one can ever imagine. But thanks to the critiques, it pushed us to demonstrate that we had understood everything. And by 2006, we had proven that this was much more accurate than any other method available at the time. It's now 2016. There isn't anything like this. The students just come in, push the button, and the pulses are compressed automatically on any device. And I think the record now is 3.8 femtoseconds. Biomedical imaging is one of the areas where we're making a very big impact. When someone develops skin cancer, it usually starts from the very top layers. And therefore, if it's detected on time and removed on time, the prognosis is really, really good. What we are trying to do to improve the concept of an optical biopsy. So you go to the doctor and the doctor says, well, I don't like this lesion. Let me look at it under my new laser microscope. They put the laser microscope and it's able to peer not on the surface, but to go to deeper and deeper layers in order to, A, is it cancer? What kind is it? And how deep has this cancer progressed? This would cut at least 2 months, which in the case of melanoma, which is a very fast progressive cancer, can literally mean a life or death difference. We're developing this technology, we call it Coherence Imaging, and we have now one publication on this, and all was done using icer. In that case, the icer was used for processing our data, according to certain mathematical formulas. Another heavy use by us, let's assume that we have some potentials and some energies and the interaction with the lasers and so on. We put all of this together into a mathematical model. The more complete the model, the more time consuming in terms of computation, so we need the speed. And then we run it through and we try to look if the results resemble our data. So that's how we use this great facility at MSU.